Bye-bye. Welcome, everyone. Adam the Woo here. No, I'm just kidding. It's Johnny2B here, and... And we're bringing our fine fanfiction, the Lion King, My Lion King 3, Simba's Pride of the Next Generation, Chapter 4, Kopa, New Adventure, and Kiera and Simba. All the music belongs to... Hans Zimmer, Tim Rice, and Elton John. And the Beatles, John Lennon, performed the Kansas City song you'll be hearing in the background. Here we go. Chapter 4, Kopa's New Adventure and Kiera and Simba. Hey kid, you awake? Strike whispered to Kopa.
Mm-hmm. Why? Kopa mumbled groggily.
Well, kid, turns out you are leaving here to be transferred to the Kansas City Zoo.
Kopa shot up like he was just lapped in a cup of espresso. Where is that? And why? He asked a little shocked.
Strike sighed. First of all, kid, I'm not sure why humans do these things. There are many reasons. Inventory, procreation, or just transferring.
Kopa looked a little bit confused. What do you mean by procreation?
Strike shuffled a little uneasily, wishing he wasn't giving in to the speech to the cub. Well, kid, sometimes zoos need animals to mate so they can replenish the population. So they don't keep capturing with new ones all the time.
Kopa's mouth dropped comically. But I only want to be with Vitani.
Strike sighed sadly. Kid, you're going to have to learn to leave the past behind you.
Kopa slowly slumped to the ground, looking as glum as ever. Strike, where's Kansas City?
Somewhere far west from here, not as populated with humans as Brooklyn, but probably less dense and spread out since it's further west. A bigger enclosure is much more spacious than it is here.
Why? Kopa asked, looking up from his misery.
Strike growled irritably. Kid, you're going to have to ask too many questions, and I am too tired to answer them all. Go to sleep.
The next morning, Kopa awoke to see a trail of meat pieces. Kopa, naive as ever, followed them, only to find himself in a steel cage. As he turned around, panicking, the cage door clanged shut behind him. Kopa looked up in fear to see two human men in white zoo suits smiling down at him. They're going to Kansas City now.
Kopa snarled, trying desperately to get it out of the cage when he felt something sharp hit his left flank and he started losing motor control and his vision slowly faded in darkness. Kopa opened his eyes to see three other lions staring at him next to a big rock. Kopa ignored them and got up to look around.
Strike was right. This place was bigger, much bigger. Kopa looked to the left and saw some zebra and giraffes, along with some animals he had seen at the Brooklyn Zoo. Kopa looked back at the lions and studied them. One had a big brown mane. Two others Kopa noticed were lionesses older than him, and there were three others. However, Kopa couldn't tell quite what gender they were. They looked like fully grown male adults, but they had no manes. Were they oversized lionesses?
Kopa started to laugh. What are you looking at? One of them strange lions demanded angrily.
You look funny, Kopa barely managed to say, choking in laughter.
Why don't you shut it, you bratty little cub? One of the strange lions shouted.
Kopa kept laughing until he felt a paw slap him across the muzzle.
Kopa fell to the ground, his muzzle stinging from the blow. Relaxion, Gaza! He's just a kid! He doesn't understand anything! One of the strange lions scolded as Kopa hit the ground. Simba, you know, you should be helping the boy up for this blow of the head he took, one of the female lionesses said.
Mufasa, you're closest. Why don't you just help him out, the lioness asked. Why don't you help him, Nala, the strange lion shot back.
Simba, Nala, Mufasa, Kopa questioned. These lions certainly didn't look like the ones he knew, especially the evil Simba. He had only heard of stories of Mufasa. Kopa honestly had no idea where Kansas City was. Was it Africa? He could only assume. Yeah, that's us, kid. What's your name?
Kopa swallowed and got to his feet, opening his mouth to speak. My name is Kopa, he thought was a friendly tone.
Jabrali, one of the tanny lions snorted. Right, another preteen lion, what we need, he said, as he snorted. You got it, bro. This boy's not going to last very long here.
What do you mean? Kopa asked, getting a little scared.
What they mean is that you got to obey the rules here, or you're dead, said the evil Mufasa. Now let this get this straight through your head, Kopa, or whatever your name is. We get all the food, and we get all and you get the scraps left behind, evil Simba said. Also, we get all the toys to play with, and you get nothing. You understand that, Kofi? Evil Mufasa explained cruelly.
Kopa was extremely offended. It's Kopa, and I understand, but can't you please just share? I was a prince in my former home.
Evil Mufasa decisively snorted at the prince. A prince? Pfft, should I bow, your majesty? He started laughing and mocking at the prince. The other lion started to jeer and exile the prince. Ha 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 ha, yeah, prince! And Kopa just started sinking to the ground. He just wanted to go home. Meanwhile, a dirty blonde-haired tall teenager named Reed and his younger brother Brett walked into the zoo. His brother asked curiously. Quiet! Mom says I gotta spend time with you, so I'm doing just that. Now keep me quiet and spread out, Reed muttered to Harold B. Reed sighed in annoyance. Oh, wise guy, huh? He smacked his brother across the back of his head. Before grabbing, then Brett, he grabbed a baseball, nowhere whacking Brett. Brett sharply hit him on the head back, thus creating a series of Three Stooges antics. Dang it, Reed! All you had to do is give me an answer! Now cut that out! Reed pulled out his brother's left ear. Reed regretfully released his brother and noticed a sign above the nearby enclosure. Ah, the lion exhibit. My favorite animal, Reed smiled as he walked towards the entrance. I seem to recall Shere Khan lost a little boy while Scar killed off the main character, Reed countered smoothly. Why, you smack! You moron! Reed slapped his brother again, jokingly this time. Then they entered the exhibit while they gathered around something, or someone.
Shut up and watch! Spread out!
Reed scolded. Reed then saw a lion, the younger lion, the rest getting into the fight, and the larger lions.
Look at him! Bite his head off, Brett yelled, his sneakers still defying gravity. The new lion was beating the other lion rather easily. It was unbelievable since the other lion was so much older than the new one. While the one Reed had seen before swung wildly, the new lion dodged all of his attacks, until the rest of the lions joined in.
Hey, that's enough! A young woman in a zookeeper's suit came up out of the door in the actual exhibit. The lions quieted down, but the new lion remained visibly agitated. I said that's enough! The lady yelled. The new lion ignored her, still advancing courageously on the older one and had been attacking. This ought to teach you! Psst, the zookeeper said, picking a large pepper spray can and spraying the preteen lioness in the face. After a single spritz, the lion immediately lay down and yelped in pain, lying to the grass and surrounded the enclosure. I don't have time for lions to disobey my orders, the she-devil said angrily before stalking the exhibit. My goodness, animal cruelty, Reed said, horrified like Brett in the scene before him. As Kopa lay down in the strange transparent material holding his nose, he found he wasn't angry anymore.
Evil, Simba had told him that he was a stupid prince, which had naturally inflamed him. When Kopa fought this other Simba, he noticed this Simba had no fighting technique to speak of. But now, all he wanted to do was go home and see his family.
Kopa looked up to see where humans were looking at him in compassion and in their eyes. He looked and wanted to see that one tall human with blonde hair. Cautiously, Kopa put his paw, staring at the strange glass that was blocking him from the two humans. Watch out! He's gonna eat us, Brett said, jumping back.
No, I think he wants our help, Reed looked strangely at the new lion. How are we gonna help him? Brett asked in disbelief.
We gotta get him out of here! No animal should be treated like that, Reed said firmly. More Three Stooges antics.
Nuts, how are we gonna get him out of here, Smarty Pants? Brett asked, forcefully earning him another slap from Reed.
There aren't any security cameras around the exhibit, stupid! The only other place that would go indoors, and the building is made of stone.
What about those little holes in the wall? Brett asked.
Just follow me, Reed jumped down to the top of the fence, staying below the top of the fence, and Brett stood on the ground and got over the other fence, and then he was on the ground of eye level.
The lions were now heading into an indoor containment unit right next to the display exhibit. Unfortunately, the lovely witch of the zookeeper was inside with them. Reed looked to the left of the pathway and saw a golf cart with a man eating lunch in the back. A light bulb turned on in Reed's head. Now, if only they knew how to get the man out of his seat.
Hey, Brett, go over there and knock his block off. We need his cart, Reed said.
Reed said, handing Brett the baseball bat as he pointed it at the cart. Brett nodded mischievously and walked over to the man. He leaned casually against the side as he began to say, Hey, Fur, could you please show me where the... Brett was roughly smashed the man across the head with the bat. The guy slumped into the ground quickly. He could almost see the cartoon doors flying around his head.
Great job, Brett. Now, my turn. Reed looked over to the enclosure in his position of the fence and saw that a lion was sitting by himself in the outdoor enclosure. Hey, Reed, he whispered to the lion below him.
The lion looked up at Reed. Listen now, I ain't gonna hurt you. The lion almost smiled and jumped in the air, claws extended.
Ow! Reed yelped sharply, and the t-shirt was torn as he was wearing, tore apart. And the lion knocked him down, and then he fell on his face. Thump! Gosh darn it, now how am I gonna get you out of here? Reed said. Reed locked eyes at Brett, and then a thought came to both of them at the same time. 5 minutes later, Reed and Brett managed to sneak Kopa out of the zoo, and we're now inside Reed's car.
So Reed planned to get just let Kopa go. Anywhere was better than that zoo. You shouldn't have put me in that pit, Reed. I could have died. Brett and the lion were riding in the back with Reed driving.
What you chewing on back there? Reed asked hungrily.
That dude's sandwich. It's ham and cheese. Want some? Brett waved the sandwich in front of Reed's face.
Ah, Brett, you're gonna make me crash! Reed swerved to the right and left, just to find a telephone pole right in front of him. Bang! Everything went black.
3 days of wandering later, Kopa was in a world that he had never seen before. Above him were strange lights all aglow, and the area was teeming with humans.
Kopa hid in the bushes and the outskirts of the strange rock road. Kopa looked up amazed. It certainly was unlike anything he had ever seen before. It was like people had replaced the lights of the sky and lights crafted by themselves. Huge skyscrapers pierced the skyline, and while hundreds upon hundreds of odors wafted Kopa the sensitive nose. But there was one smell that stood out in front of him, the smell of meat. Kopa looked down and heard his stomach rumble. He knew he had to have whatever he was smelling.
As Kopa walked through the night, he saw a sign that looked awfully familiar. Kansas City!
This was the place Strike had told him about. And what a beautiful place it was. This is indeed was a strange and interesting place. Kopa heard his stomach rumble again. Time to get a move on. Kopa smiled as he heard the Kansas City song by Fats Dammno and the Beatles play in the background. Reed, I told you there was cameras there. Reed sat there just sitting in the sofa, soda. Stop it, Reed. Daniel smacked his son across the cheek to shut him up. Go to the back of the room and calm down, Daniel instructed sternly. Reed stormed to the back of the room, right of the end of the back of the back room of Gates Barbecue sign. Stupid brother! I oughta! Reed bumbled to himself. Suddenly, Reed looked over at the back and saw the same rescued lion at the zoo. I really must be going crazy, Reed stood. And then back running straight into the oven. It's 11 p.m. It's possible, Reed mumbled to himself, fumbling around and a little scared of the lion. Don't worry, I'm not here to hurt you, Kopa said, as he moved forward. You, Reed shakenly went violently. The lion had gotten bigger and was now spotting the beginnings of a mane.
What happened? The lion asked Reed.
Reed was shaking with fear and his eyes wide as saucers. Daniel popped out of the double doors. Reed, are you? Holy crap! Daniel screamed, running out of the room to grab the phone. Yes, animal control? I need people here now. That lion is messing with my... from the zoo? He was the missing one? Yeah, I'm trying to get him using my high-priced... I mean my low-priced meat. Daniel straightened himself out as he was talking on the phone. Kopa heard the sirens and started to run. What is going on here? cars were starting to chase him down the road. Kaboom!
Nice meeting you. I hope to see you again soon. The call ended with a click. Kopa ran out more frightened than he had ever been in his life. Reed had calmed down and looked outside to see it to his horror. Police sirens. As Kopa ran for his life, a tranquilizer dart struck him in the flank, plunging his world into darkness again.
Back in the Prylands, Kiera was growing well. Today she was 5 months old. Every day she would play with Timon and Pumbaa or Dottie. However, Dottie was getting less interested as she was getting older and was starting to be taught by her grandma on how to hunt since, well, her mother had defected and her father was dead. And her lessons were more sporadic. Her grandma, Paca Camille, had to constantly fill in for Sarabi on the hunt since Sarabi was gone. That night, Kiera and Simba went stargazing at a fun fun activity.
Aren't they beautiful, Daddy?
They sure are, Simba said. His face escaped the more solemn as he turned towards his daughter. Kiera, I think it's time I share something to you that my father shared to me and his father shared to him.
What is it?
Well, you see, Kiera, your grandfather once told me that those stars are the great kings and queens of the past.
Kiera gasped in juvenile excitement. Really? So Grandma is up there with Grandpa?
Yes, I think that all good lions, such as your brother Kopa, are most likely up there since he was a good lion, too. It's clear that Simba really didn't want to answer the question. Well, I think that lions have a darkness in them to go somewhere else when they die. This is your great uncle Scar. Well, that bad lions have that darkness in them, and so they don't deserve to be up there with the good lions. Simba chuckled. Thanks, sweetie. I just want to let you know that after I die, I'll always be there for you. And I'll be in the stars to guide you, as Grandma and Grandpa are now.
Daddy, can we sleep out here tonight? Kiera asked.
Simba smiled at his daughter. Sure, anything for my little girl. And that, my friends, is the end of Chapter 4, Kopa's New Adventure in Kiera and Simba. I'm Johnny Tubi.
And I'm Hopeless Romance.
And all music belongs to Hans Zimmer, Tim Rice, Elton John.
Wilbert Harrison. Septimus. All the rest of them.
Yes, we can't pronounce them. Anyway, have a good night. Thank you.